What's up, beautiful people? We are back. That's right, we are back for episode 2 of More Life Wednesdays, man. I hope you all are ready, because today is a special day. Today is an interesting day. Today I'm going to do something that I've never done on social media platforms in about 4 years, all right? But before we can get into that, we have to flash back to episode 1. All right, now episode 1 was talking about the mind, all right? I gave you 3 things in regards to the mind. Your intellectual, your mindset, and mentality, all right? Basically, what are you giving yourself intellectually, whether it's books, music, good group of friends pouring to your mind, having a positive mindset versus a negative mindset, and the type of mentality you have that you need to get to accomplish all your dreams and your goals and etc. All right, and one thing I didn't, I just want to take this time to tell you all right now, one thing I didn't say on episode 1 about your mind, all right? Everything from stress, anxiety, and depression starts in your mind, all right? Statistics show that over 75% of Americans experience stress from work, finances, family members, and all of that. And we all know stress leads to anxiety and depression. So make sure you're taking care of your mental health. That is very important, all right? Now, let's jump into today. I'm really excited about today, all right? I've never done this before. But today is Valentine's Day. And I just want to say, I have no date. I have no Valentine's Day. Even though it's Valentine's Day, I am single, but I am content and I am happy. Not content, but I'm happy in the season that I am in my life with my singleness. So you have to be happy in that season that you're in. Now, this can go for anybody that's single. This can go for anybody that's dating, anybody in a relationship, anybody married. All you people out there Netflixing and chilling, Huluing and chilling, Fire Stick and chilling. This can go for all you all. We're just going to dive into that of being mindful. It's all focused on the mind, being mindful of dealing with your partner in whatever space of relationship or whatever season of the relationship that you're in. So I'm going to talk about specifically these times and what impacts us and what impacts me. The internet, social media, is the biggest craving thing that's going on right now. You know, we have Twitter, we have Facebook, we have Instagram, Google. I mean, whatever it is, you know, all the social media platforms. I know people out there on Tinder and Bumblebee and everything else. But being mindful of how you're maneuvering and how you're moving on social media, because many people get to see that. You get the opportunity to bring people into your relationship who are not in your relationship. You bringing others into your bedroom, all right? So I want you to be mindful of how you're moving. Let me give you an example. I talk to my friends all the time about how to move on Instagram. As we all know, Instagram will get you messed up. Instagram is telling on folks these days, all right? From you all know, when you like somebody's picture, your name pops up right there. It shows like, oh, you was liking this picture. Or when you comment, your comment shows out of the 10,000 comments under that celebrity page. It will get you messed up. So how to move. The first thing you have to put in your mind, you must be respectful to yourself and to your partner and to the relationship that you all have. Being respectful is not, if you're not respectful, it's not gonna get you anywhere. And the second thing is communication. Respect and communication, all right? The third thing is having that positive mindset when everything unfolds. So let me give you an example on Instagram. You're on Instagram, let's say you're a guy, your relationship with your woman or whatnot, or wherever you're at in your season of your relationship, you're married or whatnot. And you follow nothing but IG models. We all know what IG models are. Those the women that's out there showing their skin, giving us the angles, all those things, you know, those more sex appealing pictures and videos. And that's all you follow. And that's all you liking. That's all you commenting. And man, you think it's no harm because you don't personally know them. You think you'll never see them in life. But your girlfriend or your partner, their family and their friends, they see you liking these pictures, these videos, and that now plays into an insecurity that's going to come to your partner, and which is going to come into your relationship. Now your partner feels like, hey, that's all that you are liking, that's all that they're getting screenshots of, you're liking and commenting on it, feel like, well, maybe that's what he likes, but I look nothing like that. So that brings an insecurity, like, hey, if he finds a person, a partner that looks like that, will he leave me for that person? or she leave me for that person? So you have to be mindful how you're moving and make sure you're respecting the process of your relationship and your partner, all right? The next thing in dealing with a relationship, when this comes up, if this comes up in this example, the communication, all right? The communication, you all have to communicate effectively. You can't just be yelling at each other. Oh no, you blase! That's not gonna work. You yelling at somebody, now you put them in defense mode. Cause you come yelling at me, I'm gonna automatically get into defense mode. I'm not listening. I'm listening to reply instead of listening to understand. So when people listening to reply, all they give you is the first thing on the surface level of their mind and on their tongue, instead of when they're listening to understand, they're internalizing it and they're thinking how to critically say something back to you to get where you're coming from, your viewpoint. So your communication is big in your relationship. And I just hope you all got your pen and your paper, taking down these free notes that I'm giving you, these gems on More Life Wednesdays, all right? The third thing, that positive mindset, all right? That positive mindset that you must have. Once you communicate with your partner, you have to be able to trust and understand that the things that you all have discussed, you all would take heed to it and you all would implement it and apply it to your relationship and apply it to your life. But if you have a negative mindset, you're gonna always keep bringing up, oh, you was doing X, Y, Z, you cheated this long time ago and you was out here with this dude and all that. When you don't have a positive mindset, you have a negative mindset, all of that can bring those insecurities rushing back into your relationship. So I want you all to be mindful of that, all right? I've already said it. The communication, your mindset, and being respectful to your partner and your relationship on how you're moving on social media. There's other ways and other things that's going on in life, but I just wanted to talk real briefly to you all about social media today and make sure you're moving correctly, especially on Valentine's Day. I don't want you all getting in an argument or getting left at a restaurant today or getting left at pay yourself because you wasn't moving correctly and you didn't respect your relationship and your partner, all right? It's your man, Warren C. Moore. You already know what I need you to do. I need you to subscribe. Just right, click the button below to subscribe to the YouTube channel. I need you to like and share this video, leave a comment, and let us know what's going on, all right? Love the process. Make sure you all have a good Valentine's Day, and we out.